Found yourself needing some images, but looking for them individually doesn't seem all that exciting? Luckily, web scraping is here to save the day. Let's find out how to collect massive amounts of data using Python in a blink of an eye. The website we'll scrape today is a static one. Unlike a dynamic website, a static website's elements don't change based on specific information about the visitors. That would include things such as their age, gender, location, or payment information. Since the content remains static, these websites are easier to scrape. For a smooth scraping experience, let's first prepare all the components we'll need today. First of all, Python. We used version 3.8.9. To download it, go to python.org, then click on All Releases just under the Download section. While installing, make sure to tick the pip and add Python to environment variables checkboxes. Next, you'll need BeautifulSoup 4. BS4 is a PI package that parses HTML and XML formats. In our case, BS4 will help turn the website's content into an HTML format and then extract all of the IMG objects within the HTML. Get it by writing this code line in the command prompt window. We'll also need the PI requests library. It'll send the requests to the site and save it in the response object. Get it by writing this code line in the command prompt window. And the last, but an essential element of the process is proxies. They help shield you in the eyes of the website you're scraping and allow you to continue your work without any IP bans, blocks, or pesky CAPTCHAs. Since we're already talking about them, how about we go ahead and set up our proxies? For image scraping with Python, we recommend residential proxies. We actually have a video all about them, so be sure to check it out using the link in the description. To set up our proxies, head over to Smartproxy and click on Sign Up. Register and confirm your registration. Navigate to the left side of the screen and click on Residential. If you're new to our family, go ahead and purchase a suitable residential proxy plan. Then either create a user and authenticate with your credentials, or whitelist your IP. Now that you've set it all up, you can choose whichever endpoint you want from more than 195 countries, including any city. Oh, and if you find yourself having any trouble, be sure to consult our help documentation. Or if you crave some human contact, hit up our customer support. They're around 24/7. Now, let's create a new folder in C Drive and name it Images. Inside the folder, create a new text document and name it code.py. Open the document with a text editor of your choice. It's time to write our code. Import the two libraries we will use. Now go ahead and select the target website to scrape images from. For this tutorial, we're going to use our help docs page. Let's include our target into our code. Then define the proxy endpoint and port along with your username and password. Now let's add another line of code that will request information from the website through our proxies with a get command. Next, turn response.txt into a beautiful soup object by using BS4. Now it's time to identify all IMG objects within the HTML by using the for loop. Moving forward, let's identify whether an image has an SRC in the IMG object. Then write the line that will help us get the image URLs. Save the file. Now our code should look like this. Now let's open the command prompt and change the default directory to that in which our code was saved. Type this and press enter. Then type. If you wish to scrape only the URLs of the images, all you have to do now is press enter and get your results. But what if you want to download the scraped images? Then we'll need just a few more lines. Go ahead and save those URLs to a new variable. Then get the name of the image. That'll be the text after the slash within the URL. Now let's start a new request. This time, we'll be requesting the image itself. We'll do this for each image URL we got from the initial request. Next, open a file and name it with the name we saved before. Then write the response content to the file. Finally, let's close the file. The code will now move on to the next URL. Save the file, and you're done. Now your code should look like this. Let's run our code. After downloading, the images will be automatically saved to the same directory as our code. That's it. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. Good luck in your future scraping projects. Till next time.